amen. Get ready for the word, amen. There was one just brief announcement, amen. Our bishop sent us to the entire district, the Second Episcopal District, amen, and asked that on next Sunday that we take up a donation for education, a donation for education. So we'll be encouraging you to do that, amen, on next Sunday. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Simply look at your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I thank God for you.
I thank God for you.
Look at your other neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I thank God for you.
I thank God for you.
Amen. At this time, amen, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
I'm ready. You're about to be blessed.
You're about to be blessed.
I'm about to be blessed.
I'm about to be blessed.
If you would extend the hand towards Reverend DeLoach, say Reverend DeLoach.
Reverend DeLoach.
Pray.
Pray.
Reverend Edwards.
Reverend Edwards.
Pray.
Pray.
Brother Chris.
Brother Chris.
Pray.
Pray. Pray.
Extend your hands, amen, to Sister Crystal, amen. Say Sister Crystal.
Sister Crystal.
Play.
Play.
Say Miss Drama.
Miss Drama.
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 Great choir.
Great choir.
Send it into the pulpit and say, Pastor, let the Lord use you.
Let the Lord use you.
Because I need a word.
Because I need a word.
Stand your hands to the heavens and say, Lord,
I've come
to get my breakthrough.
Because I know
you can do anything. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. As we give honor to God, for it is Him that made us and not we ourselves. Give honor to Jesus, to Christ, who paid it all for you and for me on Calvary's cross. We give honor, amen, to the Holy Spirit. It's already here, flowing from heart to heart and breast to breast. We give honor to this great host of preaching power. And the Reverend Randolph DeLoach, the Reverend Marjorie Edwards, Christopher Edwards, amen. We acknowledge Pauline, amen, is here with us today, amen. We acknowledge, amen, this great host of leadership, this great school, this great trustee board, this great missionary society, great stewardess, great YPDers, amen. Great ushers, amen, who ushered us into the presence of the Lord today. Amen. The great men, women, and children who have assembled here today at this great, historic, and holy place of God. I want to acknowledge, amen, our children, Ms. Diamond, Ms. Jaden, Mr. CJ, here with us today. Acknowledging, amen, this great choir. Counted it not robbery to bless us today.
Amen.
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 Amen. And Sister Tyra on the drum. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Simply look at your neighbor and say, neighbor,
amen.
I thank God for you.
I thank God for you.
I'm praying for you.
I'm praying for you.
You pray for me. Now look at your other neighbor and say, neighbor.
Amen.
I thank God for you.
I thank God for you.
In Jesus' name. And all of God's children said, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
A word you can stand on. To our ushers, amen. You may be seated. A word you can stand on. Anybody know that there's power in the word of God?
Yes.
Amen. Well, it allows us to understand that though there's great power in the word of God, many don't understand the situation. Come on, somebody. There's great value in understanding the situation, because in understanding the situation, you're able, amen, to maximize the opportunity. Somebody ought to say amen.
Amen.
What are you talking about, preacher? Well, I'm reminded, amen, of a story. There was a man, and the man had lost his sight. And over the years, he ended up having a walking stick or a cane, and then he had a dog, amen, that would help him in his travels. Well, one day he was on the side of the street corner, and while on the side of the street corner, just coming across the sidewalk, the dog raised his leg and urinated on his pants.
Mm-hmm.
All right. All right.
While looking on, everyone that saw it saw the man that was blind, and the blind man reached down and simply rubbed the dog and patted the dog on the head. One of the gentlemen jumped out of the crowd and said, "I can't believe this. The dog just urinated on your pants." And the blind man said, "I understand the situation." He said, "What do you mean? The dog just raised his leg and urinated on your pants, and all you did was pat the dog and rub him on the head." The blind man said, "Yes, you don't understand the situation." He said, "Well, what is the situation?" He said, "First, I got to reach down and find out where his head is so I'll know which side to kick." Come on, somebody.
All right.
Understanding the situation. And so when we understand that there's power in the word of God, and we can apply that word to our life, it allows us to be connected to God through the power of his word.
Amen.
Amen.
Because the reality is that we live in a society that has really given new names to old sin. It's not just everyday people, but even world leaders have openly attacked the word of God. They've attacked the integrity of God's word. And we are seeing unprecedented acts of evil rear its head in different areas.
All right.
As we've seen murders violently take place in our schools. We've seen murders and acts, amen, of atrocity take place in the workplace. We've seen atrocities take place in our communities, on our highways and on our roads. And if the truth be told, we've seen murder take place even in our churches. Come on, somebody. Laws are changing, and it seems that there is a greater separation between the rich and the poor.
Yeah.
The middle class is almost non-existent.
That's right.
And we live in a society where the laws seem to change from day to day.
Yeah.
Governments shut down, and disagreement and slowness and different ideologies are rearing their heads, and it allows us to see that many of our churches across the nation are falling down because mortgages and bills are past due in excess of thousands of dollars, while the net worth of the members exceed millions.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
All right.
But the Lord sent me here today to tell you that his word is still the same.
All right.
That sin is still sin.
All right.
And that the wages of sin is still death.
Yeah.
But the gift of God. Look at your neighbor, tell them the gift of God.
Gift of God.
Is eternal life.
Eternal life.
The word of God is important, but again, we have to understand the situation. situation because many would rather spend more time on Facebook than in the life book. Many would spend more time on the internet than in intercessory prayer. Many would spend more time in laying hands on the cell phone than laying hands on a neighbor that needs a blessing.
All right.
But today I came to share with you a word that you can stand on. And I want you to know that I am on the Lord's side. And I realize that the world wants to conform us, but we must be transformed by the renewing of our mind that we may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Amen.
See, in Daniel 5, verse 27 says, you've been weighted in the balances and found wanting.
All right.
In Mark chapter 8 and 34, it says, what profit a man to gain the entire world and lose his soul?
Yes. Teach.
Well, I want to share with you three principles, and then I'll take my seat. In understanding the situation and knowing that there's a word that you can stand on, the first principle in the essence of the power of God's word is knowing what our identity is. Do you know who you are?
All right, come on.
Well, let me tell you, the world may have told you that you are nobody, and that you have no worth, or you have no value. You may have been ostracized on the job, or somebody may have told you that you never amount to anything, but according to the word of God in Matthew 5, 13 through 16, the word tells us that we are the salt of the earth.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
All right.
I don't know if you've ever tasted bone beans that didn't have any salt in it. But when you tasted some that had some salt and some seasoning in it, it changed it, and you could smell that great savory smell throughout the room. It allows us to understand that if we are the salt of the earth, that God can use us to season situations. Come on, somebody. But I want you to know that if the salt has lost its savor, wherewith shall it be salted? It's allowing us to understand that the purpose of salt is to season something.
Yes.
But if the salt has lost its ability to do that which God created it to do, then it's therefore worth nothing.
Yeah.
But to be thrown out and trampled under feet. I want you to know that you're also the light of the world. A city that is set on the hill cannot be hid, and neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel. But the candlestick, what they do is they allow it to give light to the entire house. So then if you're the light of God, then every now and then we got to believe that God will allow us to go into a dark situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Perhaps somebody that's going through a dark time might see God's light in us.
Yes.
That they might see, amen, in the presence of God's anointing on your life, that if God is no respecter of persons, that if he did it for you, he can do it for me. If he worked it out for her, he can work it out for him. If he worked it out for this individual, then surely God can work out the situation for me. Well, I want you to know that this joy that I had, the world didn't give it to me, and the world can't take it away. Well, in the presence of understanding our identity, the second principle is we've got to know, amen, the relationship of ownership. We've got to know whose we are.
That's right. All right.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
Well, in 1 Corinthians 6, 19 through 20, it says what? Know ye that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore,